Well, my subject today is something a little different from my recent paintings. I've been doing watercolours in the local nature reserve, but I thought I'd do something a bit different today. And this is the Scotney Castle, a National Trust property in Kent. It's been in the same family since 17 something or other. I think it's the Hussey family, but it's a very, very ancient old castle, the original parts, but there's a Victorian mansion has been built subsequently, but it's marvellous gardens. And as I say, it's open to the public, and National Trust property in Kent. So I'm going to have a go at this. Fantastic colours there. Lots of muted, lovely browns and umbers and reds. Raw sienna here. We can get some ochre in and some different greens. Get these lilies if we can, and the reflection. So that's my challenge for today. I don't know if you can see my sketch. Well, that's coming out. Let me see, tracking, right, there we are. Swing it a little, perhaps that's it. But anyway, you'll soon catch something when I put some colour down. I think it'll be easier then. So I think we've got to start with a nice sky wash. So I'll get a nice, fairly big brush I've got here. Chinese calligraphy brush, really. A very big one. I don't know what sort of painting you would do with this big brush. I need not detailed calligraphy. I suppose you could do the big text. But anyway, I'm just cleaning off my little well here. So I've got to keep a fairly nice blue, cleanish colour. So let's clear it up a little bit, get the worst out. And let me think. I think I'll go for a little bit of a darker one. I'm going to put ultramarine blue, which I'll show you up here. This one in the corner here, ultramarine, my palette. I've got lots of other blues. I've got cerulean blue there and cobalt blue here. So I'm just making a nice little puddle. Quite wet really, so it runs nicely. I haven't pre-wetted in this incident, so I'm going to just go with what we can put up now. Doesn't matter if it comes down over these buildings, because I'll be putting darker colours in there. But not a lot of sky there to show us. I think I'm going to put a few darker bits in to make it a little bit more interesting. In fact, in my reference picture, there were some clouds. Going off like that. And I think I can also lighten up a little bit down in this lower area. Just a little lift there. The sky is always a little lighter towards the lower part of the sky. So let's leave it at that. That's not to fiddle with watercolour. Once you've got your washes in anyway, let them dry. Now I think I'm going to do change to a slightly smaller brush. Didn't really need that big one, I don't think, that little amount of sky. But I think we'll go something, yes, here's much. Another little Chinese brush here. It's a much smaller one. So I'm going to get some, let me look. Yes, I think we better have some yellow ochre. I think will get me going with something of that brickwork. I'm going to have a drop various colours in. Yes, let's go with just a general sweep in of colours. It's wet. I can drop in other ones, which will give me the nice variety of. In fact, I need a little grayer here. I've got some Payne's grey here on my brush. And that is much darker in this area. I'll try and get these nice shapes as well, but we can do that a little bit later. This drops drier. And down this side too. Let's get a little bit of a bluey colour in down here. Yes, I think a little neutral tint, a little bit of slightly darker here, get a bit of grey, a bit of blue, Payne's grey and a bit of blue. Along the bottom here there's some as well. In these little recesses here. A few darker bits there. And in the windows there. Got some try and do a few lines to show the brick. Blocking of bricks. They'll be able to do that better when we're drier, but I I think we'll just leave this. Let's bleed in there a little bit. Now I need, actually there's, on parts of it there are some quite yellowy, ochre parts. I think I need to step that up a little bit while it's still wet. I can, well there was this ochre here. It's rather strong, but as I said, it will dry much lighter. And it will also, so I've had to lift some of that and use it down here. Right. We have a similar sort of colour here as well. Along the edge here, some reflection on the water, some moated castle. So we'll do that, and we can get a bit of grey. I think we need this bit of the moat coming down there. Got some reflections there of this bit here. More yellow here. More ochre, just drop it in to reflect this yellowish bits that we've got. Try and put a few textural marks in. That comes down there. Right. Yes, I think brownie ochre comes a bit darker here. Let's put a bit of slight hint of green. It gets a bit darker. I've got lily ponds in this area. Lilies, we'll do those in a little bit. We should put similar there. Now I've got to squint my eyes and see. Have I got it dark enough? Let's change the tone up a bit. I think this needs to be darker here. I'll put a little bit of crimson alizarin there. Dropped it into my ochre mix. So that's much darker there. If it comes down quite a bit there. Right, let's leave it there. Then I think we should get, let's try and put some of these nice colours for the roof in. I've got a nice mixture of burnt sienna here, burnt umber. That should give me some colour which we can go with. Be a little careful that I don't go over those lines that meets the sky. So I'll probably do that with a little brush when I'm closer. I'm standing back from the painting, behind the camera actually, so it's a little far away, but I want to get to obstruct the view. I can put some drop some darker colours in, I think, so we can have something dark tiles there. Chimney stack as well. Let's put some more detail into this. Let's try and get something down that roof line. Our chimneys, we can put more detail in when it's drier. Painting that dormer window in a little better. Right, and now I must do something on that domed area. Wish I could put some flecks of red in here. It was really quite red. Let's leave that. Actually, I've got some bluey elements actually, just darker there. Let's something a bit darker. Much darker there. A little shadow cast by the dormer there. Um, Now, let's get a little bit of reddish brown going down some of these other right by the side of this window, actually. Redder, I think. I need something a little redder or different colour. Yes, it's a sort of reddy orangey colour. I need on the front of the house there. Let's get that, mix them up. Yes, that's more like it. Right. Now I think I could vary in tones. Some orangey reds in just here. And let's get a bit of bluey grey going. Just up here. Yes. some darker colours, some structure here. And this piece along here, the little bit of roofing that comes down here, it's a different colour, slaty colour, I suspect something like that. And then something like this, still a little ochre there. Bleed in there, and something fairly light. Put some green here, lots of shrubs are growing up there, I think a bit more red in here, reddy streaks, something, yes, that's a bit more like it. Structures of suggestions of bricks, very old bricks. So I can tap in a few different tones to suggest old bricks. So you need to do a lot more here. Some texture to these. This old stonework here, bricks or blocks, really. Right, let's along here. I need something a lot darker. From this windows here, it's an old part of the roof, like a porch area or something across there. To darken the shadow there, and up in the corner here. Here, there's a blending of some old brick showing there. There's no line there, let's blend that out, soften that. Right. And, yes, as I said, a little reddish. And then we've got some green. Let's pick up some of my variety of different greens on my palette. So I want to put something in there. Let's get something a bit more vibrant than that. Get a bit of lid of ochre and sap green and perhaps a little viridian will give me some more interesting green. Yes, that'll start me off there. And got a lot of green in here too. Let's green growing up here. Some brighter green, so I'm going to have a bit of lemon yellow with my Hooker's green to give me something different colour there, and cascades down here actually, and into the water here, which is a darker green. So let's get some sap green going, a little bit of blue, a little ultramarine, and smudge that in along here. Of course, this is water as well. Nice dark green, ultramarine, Hooker's green. Got the variety here, different greens. Here I've got green. Some, yeah, a bit more adventurous with that. Going to introduce some summery green, sort of more reddish, more yellowy, brighter greens. You need to do that. So I'll just put some lemon yellow there. Suggest it. Leave that for the moment. Down here I have greens as well, more reflecting in the moat. So I've got green shrub here or tree. That's my reflection of it. This way. And down there I need to, along there, need some water. It's so still. The water there, it's a real mirror really. Makes quite a dark colour needed right down here. Let's get something a bit darker. Bit of Payne's grey. A hint of green, Right, let's get something, let's get these lilies in, and then we can deal with the reflection, and I've got a little more control of it, I'm a bit closer to it. So I need a number of different greens, I think. Trying to get the shape of some lily pads. They're all getting different sizes, more oval, more circular. You can see them as they're closer to us. But of course, the perspective affects the how you view it as well. Some if I do a little bit of a wash here, otherwise there'll be too much white of the paper showing through. So I think I'm going to give it a little wash like this, and then when it's drier I could come over with the shapes better for my lily pads. I think we need a slightly different green, a bit more a lighter yellowy one. Nope, that's not good. To dry my brush off. Get some some darker lilies as well. Some darker marks. I've got a group of lilies in this area as well. Right. Let's deal with that bit of. Hold on. We'll look at some more lily shapes. Let's see if we can. We need a little bit more, a little darker there, darker here. Oh, there's some darks in here as well. Just realised behind this, these plants, so that can be reflected here. It's a little recessed area. It's dark. So we've got to get that in. And our we need to get this door. Showing there. Gotta keep it in line. Dora show. And our windows be just here. And just below this woodwork, I've got to do quite a bit of darkening up here actually. For instance, that bit in there, really quite dark. And below here, is very dark element as well. Is reflected in this part of the water as well. And if it was a disturbed, if it was blowing there, of course it would, I'd have a feathered edge. It would be not as sharp as that, but it's really quite a still day there. So we can have quite sharp reflections. Darken up our window there a bit. And also that, yes, that's this element here will be darker, but it'll be in our picture here. So we've got to get that showing. Dark bit here. I need to reflect there as well. And there's a, I think a drain pipe is coming. This is a reflection of the drain pipe. Drain pipe comes from right up here. Down here. Into the water. We've got to marks here, which also reflecting in our water. Could, while we're doing some windows, we could put in this. Window there. A little bit more detail in this. That arch there. Window here. And of course we've got that one there. Could darken up a little bit. On these windows, we've got to get this sorted out up here. to get that last bit of white sorted out. So I'll use a little darkish colour with a little green in and just sweep in here. Can leave a little bit of sparkle on the water there. We'll put some things to reflect some of the reflections of the tower there. Need to put a bit more detail in our chimney there. Right, let's put some more colour into the, well, we need to put the windows in, of course. I haven't done that yet. In the top of the house here anyway. 3, 2, 3, 4 banks of three. No, not the best brush actually. Oh, this is what I should have used. Got a little flat one here, which is much more controllable. So I've got a bit of black or Payne's grey. And when do I need the 3 or 4? Let's just see how it goes. Yes. This might be a useful brush actually to see if we can do something with those lily pads. Do too much, it's going to overdo it. It'll take the spontaneity away. Of course, this is impressionistic style, it's not exactly accurate. With a dry brush, you can add a lot of texture to your paintings. Now I think I've got to do something with that roof, that domed roof. So that's a nice red, I think. I've got a variety of reds, crimson alizarin here, cadmium red, but I don't think we need cadmium red. It's more crimson alizarin red, I think. I'm going to add a bit of texture to these surfaces where you can, just varying the brush stroke. Right, and then of course I've got the top little part, haven't I? Need to get a little variety of colour in there. A little bit more red, actually. Let's see if we can lighten that up a little bit. That's too severe. I couldn't see it. You need the contrast to see it. And dark elements in there as well. Right. Right, let me see now, review the situation. Well, I've got to do this on the top, so I think I'll switch off my camera at the moment because I need to get a little bit closer to the action there. It's a bit more delicate. Brushwork needed on that little bit of iron decoration on that roof line. So I'll just switch off in a moment. I'll be back in a moment. Well, as you can see, I've done quite a lot of extra work since I last filmed. Put some more reeds in here, obscuring the lilies in the background there. Also used some gouache to redraw this window here and get the frames in a little bit better. Increase the tonal value here to have some depth to show that recess there and here, and also worked quite a bit on the water, and you can see it's got some sparkles to catch the light here just coming along, and the shadows of the door there coming in here and this window and this recessed area, and of course taking off the white tape there, so we've got a nice clean framing. All in all, I'm quite happy with it, or fairly happy. It's I tried to tighten up a little bit. It's still done in impressionistic style. It's not photorealistic, but it captures the essence of it, and of course it's glorious colours, which was my objective. And it's a good idea before you start, actually, to say, what do I really want to capture in this picture, and keep that in your mind when you paint, so that you, if you're drifting off track a little bit, concentrate on the main detail, which is the lights and darks, which is the important part in a lot of paintings, but particularly in watercolour, you need that. So anyway, I hope you liked it. If you'd like to see more of these videos, just touch the like button and subscribe, and then you'll be notified when I do more videos, so you'll be able to see them. Okay, well, that's my session for today.